This episode is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence. Like me.
Flying used to be fun until I started doing it for a living.
Once it wasn't just for the joy of it, it had took on a different hue.
It loses its shine.
What your worth is tied to, what your identity is. Instead of putting your faith in your ability to develop new talents, develop new interests, belief is a powerful thing psychologically. And when we doubt that we can accomplish things or when we're afraid that we can't, it completely changes the dynamic in our own head. And it's a really hard thing to lose something that you used to be good at. You find your passion by remembering your why.
I can't do something now.
And everything I'm good at now is something I had to learn. We all have that ability. You just have to believe in it.
Fly.
Welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Alan Seawright, a professional filmmaker who needs therapy.
I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies. What are we doing today?
You're going to react to a movie.
Which one?
It's a Studio Ghibli movie.
Ooh, delightful.
We're going to be talking about how you can get over failure and dealing with struggles in life, and how you can rescue the boy who likes you from a dirigible.
Very relatable. We've all been there.
Yeah.
In other words, how Kiki got her broom back.
KIKI'S delivery service.
Yay!
Asterisk.
How Kiki got her broom back. This is part of my Ghibli education, my Ghiblication. Because I never watched these before doing the show, and so I'm enjoying it.
This is one that I had not seen.
Yeah, it's lovely. It's delightful. Let's do it.
Hey there! Your pacifier! Ma'am, you forgot your baby's pacifier!
Oh, poor baby. Without this, the baby will wake up and cry all the way home. I better go give it to her myself.
I'm sorry, folks, but could you wait just a minute? I'll be right back.
This is your moment, Kiki. Carpe diem.
Don't shine.
Excuse me, but would you like me to deliver it for you?
What?
The woman with the baby carriage who just went around the corner. I could reach her in no time.
Really?
Please do, Mary Jane Watson.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Let's go, Gigi!
Because it's Kirsten Dunst.
Oh, yeah, right.
Oh!
That's a really fun reaction and shot, like, reveal.
The topography in this movie is really, really cool. Like, you always know where everyone is.
Yeah.
And it all makes sense.
Ooh. Sorry to surprise you, but the lady in the bakery asked me to return this pacifier.
Oh!
So she's basically Chris Reeve Superman on a broom. Just kind of goes around...
just helping people. And giggling with them. I do remember Chris Reeves giggling a lot.
Yeah. So here she hasn't failed yet, but she's finding her purpose. She's finding her mission.
Mm-hmm.
She's showing up, this is what my parents raised me for. Go be a witch in some small town and make us proud. Again, I don't understand it, but we're going with it.
Have you seen our new Cinema Therapy website? We just launched it a couple months ago.
It was so easy to build and customize our site using Squarespace.
Squarespace has so many different templates to choose from with a wide variety of styles and formats.
So once we found a template that really worked as a starting point for us, we added our own colors, fonts, and personal touches to make it our own brand and style.
We didn't even need any magic powers. Just mouse powers.
Fluid Engine, the design system from Squarespace, makes it easy to customize the templates.
They have built-in tools like video blocks and extensions for a whole bunch of platforms.
So our website can be a hub to link to our other stuff. Hubba hubba.
YouTube? Patreon? Upcoming events? Merch store?
Popcorn?
Popcorn?
Y mucho más.
Y mucho más.
Whether you need to build a website for your new delivery service.
Or your own bakery.
Or to launch your flying dirigible company.
Launch. See what you did there.
Right.
But all of Squarespace's resources, like pre-built layouts, transferred domains, customizable templates, and the Squarespace Help Center, make it quick and simple to design and build your own website.
We're all busy people, and we don't want to spend months building a website. That's why we love Squarespace.
Check out squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch your own website, or you, go to squarespace.com/cinematherapy to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or a domain.
And I like that she immediately just puts herself to service.
Yeah.
And that's super cool. And she finds joy doing that. She finds purpose doing that until things start to go like south on her.
How? How great would it be to go around the world?
She found Waldo.
It's Tombo.
Of course, you were flying since you were very young.
Is that Japanese Waldo? Is Tombo?
I don't know. Since I was his name's Tombo.
My mother used to take me with her. She taught me never to be scared.
Gosh, you're so lucky, Kiki. I wish I could fly. People like you can just fly away on a broomstick, but me, that's all I can do.
Flying used to be fun until I started doing it for a living.
Hey, oh, wait. Man. You can't not enjoy flying.
What? You're filmmaking?
Know, or literally anything.
Yeah.
But I'm very glad I came with you today.
You ever try studying something you learn in school?
Why don't I bring you here whenever
sucks
you
the
want
joy out of
train
it?
Train myself at the same time.
You're a very nice person.
Huh? You just found that out?
Sorry, but at first I thought you were such a clown.
You know, my mom says the same thing. Don't be such a clown. Quit looking up at the sky and get back to your books.
Ha. Stop dressing like Waldo.
Look at Tombo!
Hey, Tombo!
Huh?
Guess what's up, Tombo?
What?
We're gonna have a Run Forest Run moment here. We're not, but it feels that way.
Okay.
We're all gonna get to go for a ride in the blimp.
Really? Wow, that's great!
Hey, who's your friend?
That's Kiki. I'll get her to come over. Hey, come over and meet the gang, Kiki. We're all going for a tour inside the Spirit of Freedom.
Why are kids on joyrides always punks?
Why not? It'll be fun.
She made a delivery.
Rich kids have cars. I don't know.
You mean she's working at her age?
Well, I'll be.
Come on, I'll introduce you to everybody.
No thanks. See you later.
What's the matter? Hey! What are you so mad about?
I'm not mad at all, Tombo. I have a lot on my mind, so please just leave me alone.
Huh?
Super identify with Kiki, losing your love of something when you have to do it for work. Not that I still love, you know, making movies and making film. I love talking about movies, even though that's kind of our job now.
Yeah.
But there is a part of the glow that fades.
Yeah.
It loses its shine.
Once it wasn't just for the joy of it, it had took on a different hue.
Yeah.
And so if you can do something professionally that you love and you're going to love doing it professionally, that's a good fit. But if doing it professionally sucks the joy out of it, then might not be why it's in your life.
Yeah, maybe get something that pays better and still do it as a hobby.
Yeah, for sure.
That's advice that I give to aspiring filmmakers a lot. Because it is really, really, really hard to make a living being a filmmaker. It's really, really easy and so much cheaper than it was even when we were doing it to make high quality film and video now. Like,
yeah.
You can do great stuff on the weekends with your friends.
Ted Lasso talks about when you don't tell the truth, you lose an opportunity to build trust with somebody.
Correct.
Right? And she loses an opportunity to build trust with Himbo, Waldo.
Tombo?
Tombo.
Himbo?
He's got a himbo
He
vibe.
Will be a himbo, yeah. Give him a couple years.
She could say, it may not matter to you, but your friends were rude to me.
Yeah.
And picked on me, and I don't really want to hang out with them.
Well, knowing Tombo, he's going to immediately go over to his friends and say, like, hey, that wasn't cool, guys.
Yeah.
Because he's a sweet kid.
And then they could have told him to piss off, and he could have hung out with her. Or they could have mended fences. But either way.
She could have gone on a blimp.
And she could have gone on a blimp, which is flying without being paid for it.
Hey! You know, you can't be late for every meal just because you have a new girlfriend. And you can wash your plate yourself.
In the whole movie, your cat's been able to talk.
Why are you talking like a cat?
He's no longer anthropomorphized human personality.
Oh,
we lost Phil Hartman again.
No. Talk to me, Gigi. Ouch. You mean you can't speak anymore?
So why can't Gigi speak anymore? He fell in love and became more of a cat?
I can't understand anything he's trying to say.
I don't know if it's because of him or because of her.
Oh,
I think it's because of her. Because
it was her magic that was...
I'm losing my witch's powers.
If she's losing her magic,
mm-hmm.
She's lost her talking cat. He's now just a regular cat who's still super cute.
Kiki, look, it's me!
I think sports is a good analogy when people can perform amazingly and then they have a slump.
Age out of it, yeah.
Or they age
or
out
just
of it.
Slump,
or, yeah, where there's just something psychologically, there's a psychological
you get
block.
Yips.
I think this can happen sexually in relationships.
Sure.
I don't understand. This sort of thing's never happened to me before.
This can happen just with our ability to reach people. We feel like it's always been, like if you've ever had a friendship or a family relationship where it's easy going and everything's just natural, and then suddenly it's not, and you can't figure out how to get it back.
What happened?
Yeah. And it often comes down to self-doubt. I mean, belief is a powerful thing psychologically. And when we doubt that we can accomplish things, or when we're afraid that we can't, it completely changes the dynamic in our own head. And then that affects our ability to perform whatever it is we're trying to perform. And so I think we can all relate to what she's going through on that level.
Yeah, for sure.
Hi, Kiki. It's me, Tumbo. Did you see me today? I was waving at you from the dirigible because the captain let me come into the control cabin during the test run. Boy, did I have a cool time.
Hello, Kiki. Are you there?
Please don't call me anymore.
What did you say? I can barely hear you. You know what the captain said?
What? Kiki? She hung up.
What's the matter, dear? Is there anything I can do for you?
I'm still in training to become a witch. If I lose my magic, that means I've lost absolutely everything.
Kiki!
What happens if you base your life on your ability to catch a football?
Yeah.
And it's a really hard thing to lose something that you used to be good at. And you talked about aging out of things.
Sure.
Right? I used to do stunts.
Yeah.
Now I sit professionally.
Yeah.
You
it's
know,
different.
It's hard.
I had him do a stunt on a short film, and I think I still owe you for the chiropractor visits. Well,
I still had the skill. What I didn't have was the physique.
Are you okay?
I am now, thanks to my chiropractor.
Actually?
Oh, yeah, no, it was real. When she says, if I don't have my magic, then I don't have anything. That's a classic putting all your eggs in one basket of what your worth is tied to, what your identity is. Instead of putting your faith in your ability to develop new talents, develop new interests, or to find your stride again in the thing that you used to be passionate about.
Yeah.
We've got aging action stars who are still making movies, right? And they still do what they love, but they've got to adapt because their body doesn't work like it used to.
Yeah. In a lot of ways, I really identify with Kiki's journey here, because in my late 30s, I really felt like she did. I felt like I had lost the magic. I wasn't getting hired to some real professional doldrums. And I was in my late 30s. I'd been doing it already for like 12, 13 years. And I didn't have any other marketable skills. And I was terrified. It was a midlife actual crisis.
Yeah.
Like, I was not making money. And the thing that I could do that people paid me money for, nobody was paying me to do.
Yeah.
So it was like, am I just useless now? Like, is there any worth to me at all? And I didn't do well with that.
He's losing his mind. And I'm reaping all the benefits.
It took me some painful experiences to kind of get to where Kiki's going to get to.
Raise your chin up a little. Look straight ahead.
Ah, her artist friend who lives in the middle of nowhere.
Painting and magical power seem very much the same. Sometimes I'm unable to paint a thing.
Just like filmmaking and therapy.
Then what? What happens?
Kiki, please don't move. It's hard to draw a moving target.
Without even thinking about it, I used to be able to fly. Now I'm trying to look inside myself to find out how I did it. But I just can't figure it out.
You know, could be you're working at it too hard. Maybe you should just take a break.
Yeah, but still, if I can't fly...
Then stop trying. Take long walks, look at the scenery, doze off at noon. Don't even think about flying. And then, pretty soon, you'll be flying again.
You think my problems will...
go away? That's right. It's gonna be fine, I promise.
There is definitely something to be said for thinking and stressing yourself out of an ability.
For sure.
And I very much relate to this, because anything that I've learned to do, I have to get through a wall of overthinking.
Yep.
Because I don't know how to do it, and so I'm always thinking through the steps, and it just comes through repetition. Like, you learn how to do it, and it's going to be clunky, and you've got to do it enough that it just kind of flows. It just kind of happens without you thinking about it. And for Kiki, the hard thing is she doesn't, at least, she may have had a learning process that she now doesn't remember because she was so young.
Yeah.
But she doesn't remember how to fly. And her artist friend's point is, You feel it more than you think it. And because you're thinking it, you're clogged, you're stuck. And I actually do think that's really good psychological advice. Even though on the surface of it, it sounds like your problems will just solve themselves if you don't worry about them. But sometimes if worry is
the problem,
then yes, removing the worry is the
will
solution.
Solve the problem.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm. When I was your age, I'd already decided to become an artist. I loved to paint so much. I'd paint all day until I fell asleep right at my easel. And then one day, for some reason, I just couldn't paint anymore. I tried and tried, but nothing I did seemed any good. They were copies of paintings I'd seen somewhere before. And not very good copies either. I just felt like I'd lost my ability.
That sounds like me.
It's exactly the same. But then I found the answer. You see, I hadn't figured out what or why I wanted to paint. I had to discover my own style. When you fly, you rely on what's inside of you, don't you?
Uh-huh. We fly with our spirit.
Trusting your spirit, yes, yes, that's exactly what I'm talking about. That same spirit is what makes me paint and makes your friend bake. But we each need to find our own inspiration, Kiki. Sometimes it's not easy.
I guess I never gave much thought to why I wanted to do this. I got so caught up in all the training and stuff. Maybe I have to find my own inspiration. But am I ever gonna find it? And is it worth all the trouble?
Well, for example, there were quite a few times when I thought of painting something over that painting.
But it ended up being so great.
So I guess it's worth it. Today when I saw you, I thought, I want to paint. You've got such a great face.
That's why I came?
Hey, well, it's better than you cleaning my floor again. Let's turn out the lights and go to sleep.
Okay.
Sometimes the conversations in these are a little choppy.
Super weird. Super weird.
I want to laugh like that more in our relationship. Just
We should.
Now let's turn out the lights and stop the show. What are you enjoying there, Alan?
I am enjoying a birthday cake that has not been delivered by Kiki, but has been delivered by Internet Dad's Popcorn.
Birthday cake flavor of our popcorn. You can buy it in our store. Link is in the comments below.
It's really good. It's probably as good as the one Kiki delivers.
It tastes like animal crackers, except for I don't feel like I'm murdering anything between my teeth. We are laughing.
An astute observation has led to laughter.
Anyway, so we talked about before how you can lose your groove. You can lose your passion for something and also then lose your ability to do it because you get too inside your head, you're overthinking it, but also you've lost the joy of it. And going back to doing something professionally or doing something academically, for me, it's about not losing the forest for the trees because there are any number of times when I was in graduate school to be a therapist that the only thing that kept me going, because graduate school sucks, the only thing that kept me going was...
Spoken like someone with ADD.
The only thing that kept me going was remembering why I was there in the first place.
Yeah.
And the idea of sitting across from somebody and making a difference in their life, like, and doing that all day, every day, and enjoying that feeling got me through writing a master's thesis. It got me through statistics. It got me through and it gets me now through doing case notes and the side of like running a business, which is like, ugh. All of that, you find your passion by remembering your why. And that's what this conversation is about, is finding your why. What is your inspiration? By the way, it doesn't have to be something grand or noble. The sheer enjoyment of a thing is a noble purpose in and of itself.
Absolutely. Yep.
And the notion of, I almost painted over this 1,000 times, but look at where it arrived. It arrived at something beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And so there are things that are a mess and you keep going and you find it. And that's a metaphor for life. There are also times when things are a mess and you should just stop. Like that woman tried when she tried to fix the Jesus. Do you remember that?
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Just
boy,
stop. Oh
boy. Creatively, obviously, the parallels are very strong. And it's really, really, really hard to know when you should keep pushing on something and when you should walk away from something and do something else.
Yeah.
If you're trying to make a profession out of it, that's when it gets really hard to know, because the stress of, I have to earn money from this, is piled on top of it. If it's a hobby or something that you do for the joy of doing it, there's less pressure to walk away, but there's still, at a certain point, if you are a novelist for a hobby and you've been plugging away rewriting the same novel for 30 years, try writing another one.
Yeah. or walk away for a while.
Uh-huh.
And then come back to it. Like, that's all good advice.
Yeah.
Please, sir, may I use your broom for a minute?
What?
Please, I promise I'll bring it right back.
Huh? I'm not gonna give
you
my broom.
Thank you
very
much.
Hey!
Luigi, stop her! Because he looks like Mario. Also, he's got a broom on his face. There's a lot of jokes there.
Yeah. Love how it goes to silence for this. She's so focused.
You will give the people of Earth an ideal to strive towards. Oof.
That was a wicked fight.
Oh my gosh! Are you Boston now?
Fly.
I love that she needs to do this thing to save her friend, and she gets the power back, but she sucks at it. She doesn't just immediately become amazing.
We have two-thirds of a movie without any conflict or real, like, stakes, and then suddenly at the end
it's
everything.
Huge.
Yeah.
The young boy has somehow managed to keep his hold on the rope, but how can anyone rescue him now? That brave young boy is hanging on for dear life. He can't. Something just flew by. Bird? No, it's not a bird. It's a young girl.
See, it's not a bird. This is very much
a bird.
Witch soaring through the sky, and she's right
there. Oh,
Kiki!
She can fly again.
I love the old lady who's like obsessed with things exploding on TV.
Uh-huh.
Be a good broom.
Oh, easily my favorite character.
Hang in there.
Because there's a professor muttering a curse somewhere, making the broom go crazy.
She's trying to reach the boy!
Yes. Don't give up now, sonny!
Come on!
Don't give up!
The animation's so cool on that.
So great.
Yeah. She got it.
Again, going completely silent so that it can erupt with noise. That's a little filmmaking trick to make it hit harder.
Why are they just running underneath him now?
Now.
Where were these guys?
Also, why don't firemen have trampolines anymore? Did they ever have trampolines, or was that always just cartoon?
I don't know.
That broom she used was mine. That was my broom, you know.
That guy has the most me energy ever. No, you can't use that. Totally me.
It's me all the way.
If it hadn't been for my broom, wouldn't have happened.
I like when she's bouncing off the walls and she doesn't expect it, and then by the third bounce, she uses her feet to push
like,
off.
She's okay.
she's like, okay, she adapts quickly. She finds it because she has to.
Yes.
This isn't a love of flight thing. And I also think that's why she's not flying clean, is because when she didn't have to think about it and there wasn't a lot of stress, she could just do it.
Yeah.
Now there's a life on the line. She's freaking out. She's panicked. This is why, by the way, I think it's so important to practice differentiation, where what someone else is feeling, you don't have to feel, especially if you're in a position to help. Like, the last thing I want is a panicked paramedic, right?
Yeah.
Like, if I'm freaking out, I don't need the paramedic coming and joining with me in that emotion.
That's the last thing you want.
We don't need solidarity in that moment. We need calm. And, like, if there were the further adventures of Kiki, I imagine, like, the further she gets her groove back in situations like this, now that she's done a rescue, in the future, she probably wouldn't be all over the place because she's like,
probably not.
I got this. I've done this before. But that speaks to what I was talking about before. The repetition of something. Everyone I know who actually plays the piano, they don't have to think about it anymore.
Right.
And it's the same thing with learning a new language. It's the same thing with learning a new skill. And the thing that I take comfort in when I get in my head of I can't do something now. Yeah.
Yeah.
And everything I'm good at now is something I had to learn, including things I don't have to think about anymore, like driving and walking.
Sure.
You know, we all have that ability. You just have to believe in it and then say, okay, got to get those reps in.
Okay, do it again.
Oh, I think for most of us, joy is the greatest motivator, right? That positive, we want joy in our lives. We want to do the things that make us happy.
This is where we're different. I think it's fear.
You think fear is the greatest motivator?
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei!
Positive, negative, yin, yang.
I think fear is probably the greatest immediate motivator. But building a life around fear is not going to go well.
No, building a life around fear is not great. Fear in this moment, huge motivator, totally worked.
Yeah.
Joy long term,
yeah,
is what you're getting at.
Her joy is helping people. It always has been. Like when she started slowly having problems is when doing deliveries didn't lead to happiness for people.
Right.
Like she would get the order wrong or it'd lead to stress or somebody wasn't appreciative and it sucked the joy out of it. And here she's helping somebody. And so I think that's how she gets her groove back is, yeah, fear got her up on the broom again.
Mm-hmm.
Like fear for him and for his safety. Why? Because she cares about him. And then when she helps him, she gets that joy and now she's back on the broom, right?
Yeah.
And I also think she's in a place at the end of the movie that she's not going to please everybody doing what she loves. Yeah. Before, she's really unsure. She's insecure. She wants the applause and she wants the acceptance and she wants the people to appreciate her. And now she's like, not going to get it from everybody. And that's okay.
That's right.
And that's a way to live your life.
It is. And that's for me getting over my loss of magic moment came from I legitimately started looking into what it would take to pivot into other careers.
Mm.
And when I started doing that and kind of got out of my own head, it restored my faith in my ability to like, oh, I've still got the magic. I can do things that people value.
Yeah.
And it was the big leagues, right? I'd moved to LA and people were offering me jobs on like TV shows and stuff. And it was like, oh, I'm not just some idiot. I'm that kind of idiot.
As your friend, should I say no?
No, working in television requires a special kind of idiocy. Everyone who works in TV knows.
So question for you watching, how do you work your way out of a slump? How do you work through failure? And how do you find your way back to what you love? What brings you joy? Mm-hmm. How do you do that? Let us know in the comments below because we want to share in your journeys.
So until next time.
You've got such a great face.
That's why I came. Let's turn out the lights and go to sleep. And watch movies. Weird energy in the dark. We want to thank our patrons because they get early ad-free director's cuts things. People like
Jamie,
Lauren Wheeler,
Zale S,
Justin Vanegas,
Emily Geiger. And you too can hear us butcher your name on camera. Become a patron today.
Exciting.
Is that not great salesmanship, is it?